guys. So, now we will discuss about the distribution of power, especially distribution of power in Indonesia. In the previous video, we discussed about power of politics and outlined the distribution of power according to Montesquieu. Apart from the opinion of Montesquieu, there is also the opinion of John Locke about the distribution of power, namely, first, legislative power, the power to make or form laws, and the second, executive power, the power to implement law, including the power to adjudicate every violation of the laws, and the third, federative power, the power to carry out the foreign relations. Well, so the opinion of the Montesquieu is a revival of the opinion of John Locke. By Montesquieu, federative power, but put into executive power, the function of judging is made into an independent power. This power is exercised by different institutions which are separate in nature. Then, the distribution of power in Indonesia. The mechanism of distribution power in Indonesia is fully regulated in the 1945 Constitution. The distribution of power consists of two parts, namely the horizontal distribution of power and the vertical distribution of power. Okay, let's discuss one by one. And the first is the horizontal distribution of power. The distribution of power according to the function of certain institutions like legislative, executive, and judiciary, based on the 1945 Constitution, horizontally the distribution of state power is carried out at the central government and regional government levels. The distribution of power at the central government experienced a shift after the amendment to the 1945 Constitution of the Republic of Indonesia. The shift in question is a shift in the classification of state power, which generally only consists of three types of power, into six types of power. What are the six types of the power? Let us examine one by one. The first is constitutive power, the power function to amend and stipulate the constitution. The power is exercised by the People's Consultative Assembly or MPR. The second, executive power, the power function to carry out laws and the administration of the state government. The power is vested in the president and vice president. The third, legislative power. This power function to form laws. The power is held by the People Representative Council or DPR. And the fourth, judicial power. This power function to administer the judiciary in order to uphold law and justice. The power is vested in the Supreme Court and the Constitutional Court. The five, examinative or inspective power. This power, the function as an examination of the management and responsibility of state finance. And the power is exercised by the State Financial Audit Agency. The sixth, monetary power. The power function to determine and implement monetary policy, regulate, and maintain the smooth operation of the payment, and maintain the stability of the value. This power is exercised by Bank Indonesia as the central bank in Indonesia. And distribution of power at the regional government level takes place between equal regional institutions, namely the regional government as regional head and deputy regional head, and the Regional People Representative Council or DPRD. At the provincial level is governor, deputy governor, and the provincial parliament or DPRD provinsi. Then, well, at the district or city level, the division of power takes place between the district or city government, region, and deputy region, or mayor and deputy mayor, and the district or city regional representative council or DPRD district and city. And the second, the vertical distribution of power. The vertical distribution of power based on the power is the distribution based on the levels, namely the division of power between the level of central government and regional governments. This vertical distribution of power emerged as a consequence of the implementation of the decentralization principle in Indonesia. Thus, the central government delegates government authority to autonomous regional government to manage and regulate their own government affairs in their region, except for governmental affairs which fall under the authority of the central government, namely authority relating to foreign policy, defense, security, justice, religion, monetary, and fiscal.